What's up, everybody? This is Danny, and today I've partnered with Mediatek to show you one of my new favorite rooms in the house. Welcome to my ultimate home gym tech tour. First thing before I want to get started is in no way do you have to spend a lot of money to get fit. There are plenty of alternatives. This is a small loft upstairs that we converted to a home gym. And the best thing about having a home gym is I don't care how silly I look when I'm exercising. I don't have to be self-conscious and I don't have to worry about other people's sweat funk. We have a little bit of everything. We have Tonal, we have Peloton Bike Plus, and I have a Samsung TV that works perfectly with Apple Fitness Plus and the Apple Watch. Also some cool random things like the ceiling fan here that's made for low ceiling heights. We also have a console over here that we can keep all of our shoes and weights under, and a pretty sweet little Xbox mini fridge. I wanna thank the sponsor Mediatek for powering a ton of tech that's in this gym. And if you're a fan of tech, then you've probably heard of them already. But if you haven't, they provide processors for everything from smartphones to smart home products like the new Amazon Echo 10 that I use to control my smart home, the smart bulb and smart plug that I'm using in the gym space. It is also powering the Tonal that is on the wall. Previous versions of Peloton have run on MediaTek processors. They power speakers, Wi-Fi routers, TVs, headphones, the list goes on and on. I will leave a link down below for you so you can see for yourself how much tech runs on MediaTek. It's insane. The first thing I wanna talk about is Tonal, and I can't believe that I've already put in over 60 workouts and I've completed about 4 programs, so I am speaking from experience. If you aren't familiar with Tonal, it's a full body workout machine that has adjustable arms to give you over 170 different movements with up to 200 pounds of magnetic resistance. It's got a large touchscreen, so it's easy to use. And the best part is it doesn't get in the way. It is flush mounted on the wall, and I keep all the accessories that it came with in this small wicker basket, and I tuck the bench right under the Tonal. So when I'm not working out, the space stays clean. So here's some things that you need to know if you're considering Tonal. The installation is done professionally. So when you order it, what you do is you upload a picture of your space. They ask you to measure a few things, make sure you have a power plug near, and then they ask you what kind of materials on your wall so they can determine if Tonal is a fit for your space. The installation process was great. The installers were fantastic, but you do definitely need to check the website. I'm gonna leave a link down below for you because there is a little bit of a waiting time because of how popular this thing is. It took me a few months to get mine. The reason why I like Tonal so much is because I'm not the best when it comes to working out efficiently, so I found having instructors guiding me really helped. If you want those guided workouts with instructors, then you will have to pay a monthly fee, but I get this question all the time. Can you work out on Tonal without the monthly subscription? And the answer is yes. All you have to do is go into free workout mode and it'll list all the exercises that Tonal offers. And you can even build these into blocks and create your own workouts. So yes, you can do that. There are a good amount of choices for instructors, so you should be able to find ones that fit your workout style. When you're working out, the instructors give you tips on how to improve your form. The smart AI on Tonal detects shortcomings and tells you how to correct your form for better results. Even the weights are dynamically adjusted, so if you're flying through the first set, then it will increase the weight, but if you're struggling, then it will decrease the weight. I also like that you can see your workout data in real time, which is neat because you can see if you're improving or not. And then it calculates all of that at the end and it quantifies it all so you can track your workout journey. MediaTek did a great job powering the Tonal. It's fast, it's responsive, it's fluid. My Wi-Fi has been solid. My Bluetooth connection is also great, especially with the Apple Watch. And I've received a lot of software updates since I've owned this. I think I'm at least getting one a month. It brought new features like virtual group workouts where you can work out with a friend if they have a Tonal. And if you want to work out with a friend in person, you can do that. And it will track both of your results separately, which I really like. So I'm really happy with the software updates that have come to Tonal so far. So overall, it's really easy to use. You may have to get used to repositioning the Tonal arms, but once you get used to this, it will become second nature. It even gives you a guide for the correct placement right on the screen. It's super easy to attach the different accessories. You just push and you twist, it locks, that's it. And the handles have a button on the side to turn and turn off the weight. And the bar has a little sensor on it that you can attach and that does the same thing. The resistance feels smooth and natural. There are so many exercises that you could do, and I've never had a problem where the interface lags or disrupts the workout, so it's been great so far. I love that the Tonal pairs with the Apple Watch. I use this every time. It automatically tracks the workout, gives you the live heart rate data on the screen using the Apple Watch's sensors. You can turn the weights on and off from the watch, which is useful for the rope accessory, and you can also increase or decrease the resistance from the watch if you need to. Music by default is powered by Tonal Playlist. You can pick which genre that you want, but if you want your own custom music on here, you can integrate your Apple Music playlist on here, which is a nice integration. Also, the speakers that are built in are pretty decent. I can't demo it for you because copyright and all that, but you don't have to use the external speakers because you can just connect any Bluetooth headphone that you want. When I first got this thing, I didn't think that I was gonna like it as much, but I genuinely enjoy working out on Tonal, and I've never worked out so hard in my life. But if you're not into muscle training, then there are plenty of choices here. You have yoga, you have Pilates, high intensity, pre and postnatal workouts. You also have boxing and kickboxing. So this is legit a full home gym. Usually when I jump off of Tonal, then I'm jumping right on this, the Peloton Bike Plus. And I actually own the original bike as well. And I thought this was worth the upgrade. First, you get a much bigger screen than the original bike and it pivots. So you can do those cool boot camp workouts on and off the bike. And I also like this full tilt here because this is the viewing angle that I like when I'm on the bike. Plus the speakers are so much better, more depth, more bass. I mean, just everything. It's a noticeable difference. And even though they did change the headphone position, which I really like, I usually just end up working out with the external speakers. That's how good they are. But if you have the older bike and you have a wall mounted TV like I do here, here's a little tip. You can actually use Miracast or Chromecast to put the display onto the TV. So when you hop off the bike and you're doing boot camp exercises, that's a nice little hack right there. The resistance system is different on the new Bike Plus. I personally like the old one better, but this works as well. The big benefit that I think a lot of people will like is the auto follow feature. While I don't use it all the time, it's really nice when you just want to ride and you don't want to mess with the resistance and you just want to go by the guidance of the instructors. So when they say pull the resistance up by 10, it automatically does it for you. So you can just ride and concentrate on the workout. I do feel like the Bike Plus is a little bit smoother while riding as well, and there are some aesthetic changes to the newer bike, but if you're happy with your older Peloton bike, then stick with it because the core experience is pretty much the same besides gym kit support. This is the only model that supports this level of Apple Watch integration like this. Before you start, you just lightly touch on the Peloton logo at the top of the display. You just confirm and that's it. All your heart rate monitoring and calculations are done through the Apple Watch, and I find it to be pretty accurate. If you're already a Peloton bike owner, then you know, but this is the thing that I always tell people if they haven't bought a bike yet. Yes, the bike is high quality and it's nice, but you're really buying in to the Peloton community. The instructors are top notch, and when you first jump on here, you might be overwhelmed at the amount of instructors on here, but you will find your favorites. And it's really like riding with a friend. You get invested in their lives, you follow them on social media, you love the stories they tell. Some people are just upbeat and energetic and make you feel good when you're riding, and then some of them will just literally kick your ass and make you take it to the next level. And unlike Tonal, there are live classes, so you can jump in and experience that ride for the first time with a bunch of other people as well. No matter what, I always end up looking like this at the end of the ride where I'm just sweating to death. It's a good workout every time, but you can do as little or as much as you want. You can choose anywhere between a 10-minute ride to a 90-minute ride. Theme rides are fun too. They just did a Beyonce collab and they're doing Versus artists right now. And if you just want a relaxing ride, you can always just free ride and enjoy the scenery that's on there. But there's also tons of other exercises in here. Talked about boot camp earlier. There's stretching, yoga, meditation. So you do have a lot of choices with Peloton as well. While there are other spin bikes with live instruction, Peloton's instructors are, I think, on another level, and it's literally the core of the Peloton community. I just hit over 100 rides and I understand why now. Peloton is legit. Last thing I want to talk about is Apple Fitness Plus. This is the cheapest out of the bunch because it's a $10 per month subscription, or if you pay yearly, I think it ends up being about $7. And then if you're bundled into an Apple One plan, then this is also included on that one monthly bill. The only downside is if you're not an Apple fan, you have to have an Apple Watch and an iOS device of some sort, like an iPhone or iPad, to make this work. Sorry, there's no Android support here. There are a few reasons why I picked this Samsung TV. Number one, it's affordable. And number two, it has AirPlay built right in, so I can just use AirPlay to work out on the big screen wirelessly. At the time that I was making this video, it's not available. That's why you see this wire right here, but it should be available anytime. What I like about this is that it's really simple. You just pick a class that you want to join. Your Apple Watch just starts monitoring the workout right away. I think this is one of the best fitness apps for beginners because if you just don't want to overthink it and work out, this is definitely going to be a fit. I love the fact that you get your fitness rings displayed right on the screen and you can see the ring starting to close in real time. All of your metrics like your heart rate are displayed too, and with certain workouts you get a burn bar to show you how hard you're working out in comparison to others. Lots of trainers here too with tons of diversity. I think you'll find an instructor that you'll definitely like. The video quality is also very good on these pre-recorded workouts, so I really appreciate that. Since release, they added time to walk so you can take a walk while you're listening to topics from your favorite celebrities. There's a lot of people to choose from, so this is a great feature if you like to walk. You can cycle through your favorite instructors and filter by workout types and how long you have to work out, so that's nice. Another way Apple Fitness Plus is great for beginners is that there are different levels of intensity right inside the workout. So there usually are two people next to the main instructor that are giving you alternative moves just in case the main move is too hard for you. So I think a lot of people will appreciate this because they won't get discouraged. They can do the alternative moves and keep their fitness journey going. Since you only need an Apple Watch and an iOS device, this means that you can bust out a workout from anywhere, especially if you're traveling, so you don't have to miss out on closing your rings. I hope to see this platform grow and improve. The one thing I would like to see is easier filtering of muscle groups. So if you want to just work out arms, let's say, or just focus on chest, you should be able to search that from your home screen. And while there are episodes like this for beginners, I would love to see more curated programs on here. Now, it does suggest your next workouts from your workout history, but I would like to see more tailored programs in the future. To take full advantage of Apple Fitness Plus, you might need to have a gym membership to enjoy the spin, rowing, and treadmill classes, but this is a great option for people already in the Apple ecosystem and want to work out. Plenty of choices here as well with yoga, thoughtful cool down, and there are a lot of workouts to choose from where you only need just a couple of dumbbells. So if I had to rate my home gym, I would go Tonal first, Peloton second, and then Apple Fitness as a supplement to these two. I guess the big downside is that it's expensive. So Tonal is the most expensive and then Peloton second. But with the combination of all these things, I'm definitely never going back to the gym again. But everybody's different. You have to go with what's best for your fitness journey. So let me know what you think about this space. What can I add to make it better? And I hope this video helped you out if you were deciding on Peloton, Tonal, or Apple Fitness Plus. If this helped you in any way, make sure you hit that thumbs up button. Subscribe to the channel for a lot more cool tech videos like this. And I will see you in the next one.